Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel Info Aviation. Today's video is special, the only video about this topic. Why do planes sound low at night? So let's get started. If you Google this up, the first thing that you shall see makes no sense at all. It says something about temperature. It's wrong. Completely wrong. Google wants to say, in short, that sound travels slower at night. But even if it travels slower, won't it reach you? For example, you are going to New York to Los Angeles by road. There was a lot of traffic, so you reached late. But you reached even late if you will reach at the destination. The same thing with sound of jet engines, and plus the difference is very less, so it will take a few more seconds. So now we'll tell you the real thing. There are some rules that are followed by planes during the night to let you have a good night's sleep. Firstly, the traffic at night is a bit less, but planes also travel at night, so what about them? The planes usually take a different route. They will come over the water bodies, and even if they have to turn, they'll come by sea route only. What if the airport's in the middle of city, you ask? This situation, planes will come from the less populated areas. Now, sound should be heard in less populated areas at least. Here the main rules come in picture. Engines have something called reverse thrust. We have a clip about it, please watch it, and I request you to decrease the volume. So, did you hear that? Loud, wasn't it? During landing, the reverse thrust is used to stop the plane. But at night, pilots don't activate reverse thrust. Also, it won't have much of a difference in stopping of the plane. If the pilot feels unsafe, he can use it. And reverse thrust is just like a reverse gear in your car. Now, this was about landing, which is not as noisy as takeoff. During landing, the thrust is not at full, but during takeoff, it is at full. But there are rules for takeoff as well. The first one is NADP2. In this, the plane quickly reaches 1000 feet after takeoff and 3000 feet before it reaches the city. So as it is 3000 feet above the ground, it won't disturb your sleeping. And the full form is Noise Abatement Department Procedure. But what if the airport is in the middle of city? Here comes into picture NADP1. Or Noise Abatement Departure Procedure 1. In this, the plane quickly, yes, even more quickly, has to reach 1000 feet and 3000 feet before it reaches the main population. And after reaching 3000 feet in both NADP1 and NADP2, the plane will start normal climbing to its altitude as the pilots had decided in the flight plan. During the night, the pilots also don't use 100% thrust. They use Tuga thrust, which varies from plane to plane, which is between 70 to 90%, but 70% is rare and not in all places. So if you have any question, please ask us in the comments. This is all for today. Please like, share and subscribe our channel. Aviation is the future, and this channel is dedicated to make aviation safer. Thank you.